Hi guys, welcome to my video and my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to make a tutorial where I talk about branches, what they are and how to use them. We will be creating a special attack, which is an area damage effect, which also spawns some particles, and it will have a 5-second cooldown, which we will be building using branches. So hopefully after this tutorial you will know what a branch is and how to use it. So sit back, grab a cup of coffee and some popcorn, and let's begin. I will be using my own project for this, as I has more assets available, like particle effects and things like that. But it should be the same to you. If you're using the third-person template, it works the same way. Alright, so let's open my character. And let's go into the event graph. I can just close all this. Let's just close all this, so you're not getting confused. Yeah, so it will probably look like this on your machine. So this is my character. Let's go to an empty space. Just ignore all this. Ignore all this. We won't need it. Let's go to an empty space. I want to use the attack when I press the Y button on my controller, which is called face up in Unreal. All right. So let's right click, empty space, type in face up, and get this one face up. All right. So when I press the face up button, the Y button, I want to create a radial damage. This will just create a radius, and everything in the radius will be damaged, right? I set the damage radius here, let's say 500. And I wanted to do, let's say, 2 damage. This requires that whatever is getting hit is having the receive damage node. Alright, let's compile. It will give me an error. It needs, you can see down here, it needs an origin. It needs to know where to spawn the radial damage from, where in the world. And we want to spawn it from the character. Alright, so here we have my character. It's a mesh and it's a capsule collider. Then there's some other stuff, but we don't need to worry about that. I want the radial damage to spawn from the center of the capsule. Right? This is the center of the capsule. If I select the mesh has the center down by its feet. But I want to spawn it from the capsule. So I go up here to the left, I drag the capsule component down into the blueprint, and from here I drag out and I type in location. We want to know the capsule location in the world. Get. So we have the get world location. Alright, this node will get the location of the capsule component in the world, which is my character. So I drag it into origin and then we say compile. So right now this radial damage should spawn from the center of the capsule and in a radius of 500, dealing 2 damage. All right, let's see, let's press play. All right, I press Y. And we does damage. It doesn't really do 2 damage as I want. And it's damaging the player, which is really bad. Alright, why is it damaging the player? It's because it needs a damage causer. It needs to know what is causing the damage, so it doesn't damage the damage causer, you know. If you fire off a spell, you don't want it to damage yourself, right? So the damage causer is our self. We drag out from the damage causer, type in self, get a reference to self. And self is this blueprint, it's the character blueprint, my character, right? So my character is the damage causer, so we won't, now we won't get damaged by the ability. So let's try again, press play. See, I'm not getting damaged now, but everything else is. But the damage numbers are really weird. And that is why we need to check this, do full damage. I don't know why I set the damage to 2 when it does, and it does a random damage. So just set it to full and it will work. All right, so far so good. We can't really see the damage, so now I will make an emitter, spawn a particle system, so we can better see what's going on, right? So I drag from the execution, I type in emitter, and I select spawn emitter at location. So spawn emitter at location, and this spawn radial damage at location. This is the location, the radial damage at spawn. Nothing of this carries over to this, so we need to again set where to spawn the particle system, and we want to spawn it from the character, from the capsule component, like this. That should, and then I need to select the particle system. Let's say explosion level 3. Yeah, I have some explosions. So every time I press the button, an explosion particle should go off. Yeah. The radius is bigger than the explosion, but doesn't matter. And now I can use the explosion all the time. And the damage is correct. 2 damage. Alright. So what happens when I press the Y button, the face up on the controller? It will create a radius that does 2 damage, but not to myself. And it creates it in this location, the capsule component location. And after that, it creates a particle explosion. This happens so fast that it feels like it happens at the same time, but it actually is happening in an order, right? All right, so now what I really want to talk about are the branches. We don't want the character to be able to just spam this fireball special ability. So I want to make a cooldown, so it takes 5 seconds for the ability to be ready again. And we do this by using branches. Alright, so let's make a branch. Right click, type in branch. Here's the branch. So this is the first thing we want to do when we press the button. We want to check if we can use the ability or not. A branch is basically just a node that needs a condition, and if the condition is true, then it moves on through the true execution line. If it's false, it goes down to the false and nothing happens. See, there's nothing connected to false. So when you press the button and this is false, nothing happens. Right, let's test it out. I press the button, nothing happens because the condition is false. So we need to create a condition. Let's go down to variables, plus create variables, and call it can use special attack, right? And up here to the right, you can see it's a boolean. If it's not a boolean, you need to click it and find the boolean here and click it. All right, and let's compile. So now we have a condition that is called can use special attack, that is right now set to false. I can set it to true, false. I do that here. In the beginning of the game, we want it to be true because we want you to be able to use the attack immediately. So set it to true. Then we can drag in the can use special attack condition here. We get it. When we get it, we kind of want to get if this is true or false. Then we put it in here, right? So this node here can use special attack is the exact same as this node down here. Can use special attack. It's the same thing. If I set this one to false, this one is also false. So it's the same thing, right? But let's set it to true and compile. So now he can use the attack. Now we want to make a cooldown. All right, so let's drag out the can use special attack. Instead of clicking the get, we don't want to get it, we want to set it. I set it. So after you have used it once, we set the condition to false, which means we don't click this one. It needs to be empty. When this is empty, now this will be set to empty. It is true here, but when this has fired off, this will be false. Does that make any sense at all? It's a little difficult to explain. We press the button, we check if you can use the attack. If we can use it, we go further here. We fire off the damage, we fire off the emitter, the particle, and after that we set it to false. That means this is now set to false, which means we can't use it now. It will go out of the false one here. Let's test it out. Yeah. All right, I use it. And then I press again. I can't use it because it is now set to false. The last thing that happened in the execution line was that we set it to false, and it will stay false forever now. So what we need to do is we want to create a delay, and then we need to set it to true again so we can use it. So drag off from the execution line here, type in delay. There we go. We can set the duration to 5, which means 5 seconds. After those 5 seconds, we want to set the can use special attack again. So we don't get it, we set it. And then we set it to true here. Right? So when the effect has fired off, we set it to false. We can't use it now. Then we wait 5 seconds. After those 5 seconds, we go further on here, and then we set it to true. So we can use it again after 5 seconds. So these two nodes, these two sets, are affecting this one. It is setting this one, right? Which is the condition for true or false if we can use the ability again. Let's try it out. So fire it off. I can't use it now. I'm clicking, nothing happens. We need to wait 5 seconds. Then we can do it again. And then it's off. Right. So every 5 seconds, I can use this ability. Yeah, I get a lot of errors here, but it works anyways. So that's basically it. That's how we use branches. Then we can kind of select all this, press C. Then we can type in use special attack with cooldown. All right, so last time we pressed the button. I keep explaining this because it took some time for myself to really understand what was going on. And when I understood it, things were really taking off, and I'm using this system for everything. I'm checking everything all the time, checking if the character is attacking, checking if he's jumping, checking all kinds of stuff before I can do certain things, right? But this is a very simple example, and you can use it for everything, right? So I hope you you found this tutorial useful. I will try and make more tutorials on topics that I really needed to know when I started out. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time.